Hello friends, most welcome to English Advantage online classes. Friends, in this particular video, we are going to discuss best English questions for all banking exams, particularly IBPS clerk bank exam that is going to happen in December month. So let us get started with these questions. Now these are the new pattern spotting error questions. Now in this particular question, what you are supposed to do is that one sentence is given and the last path is already a correct path. Now out of the remaining four path, you have to find out one part that is correct. So apart from this already correct path, you have to find one more correct path in the remaining paths. I hope you understand this question. Let me explain you once again. This particular path is correct. Okay, now in the remaining four path, one more part is correct and remaining three part are incorrect. So you have to figure out that correct part, and that will be your answer. Now let me go through this sentence. Although huge chunk of Indian direct selling companies initially started in South India, many of them has pan-India operations today. Now if you look at this sentence, you will come to know, look at this particular part. Started in South India, many of them. Do you see any error in this path? This path is already correct. Okay, so you can directly tick mark this path as your answer. But for the explanation, let me explain the entire sentence. Although huge chunk of, now chunk is a kind of path, huge is an adjective. Okay, so before this adjective and noun combination, we have to put here A. Although a huge chunk of Indian direct selling companies started. Now started is a verb and verb is modified by adverb. So here you have to write companies initially started in South India, many of them. Now many of them being plural, we have to use here have pan-India presence. So which part is correct in this entire sentence? In this sentence, this part is correct. Started in South India, many of them. Okay, so question number one, your answer is third. So that is how you have to solve these kind of questions in test series as well as in real exam situations. Now let us see the question number two. As a result of the lack of clarity, a number of fraudulent activities in the industry have increased, and legitimate direct selling is to be confused with Ponzi schemes. You must be knowing Ponzi schemes. Ponzi schemes means fraud schemes, like some MLM companies and some other member making companies. Most of the companies are Ponzi schemes. So Ponzi schemes means fraud schemes. Now in this particular sentence, we are comparing direct selling companies, legitimate direct selling companies, with the fraud schemes. So let me go through from here. As a result of the lack of clarity, now this part seems to be correct. Okay, so you can approach these kind of sentences in this way also. You can directly figure out the correct part that seems to be a correct part, and then you can go through the entire sentence. As a result of the lack of clarity, a number of fraudulent activities. Now this part also seems to be correct, but two part cannot correct. So there must be an error here. Sorry. A number of fraudulent activities in the industry. I think in place of a number of, that means plural, you must say the number of fraudulent activities, because the number means counting and counting is always singular. So in place of a number of, you can say a number of fraudulent activities in the industry has increased. Please notice this thing, that a number of is plural and the number of is singular, because the number of means we are talking about number that is singular. Okay, so has increased, and legitimate direct selling is being confused, because action is being done by the public. Direct selling is being confused with Ponzi schemes. So that is how you have to find it out. Now in this particular sentence, this part is correct. Here in place of a number of, you have to say the number of. Here this has the number of, and here you have to say direct selling is being confused. Okay, So in this particular sentence, this A part is correct. Now let's head and see this question. Question number third. The economy's external count could come under pressure. Now, at the first look in this entire sentence, this part seems to be correct. Just see, could come under pressure. There is no error in this sentence. Now, could is followed by first form of the verb, and under pressure is a phrase. So this part seems to be correct. Now, here I want to mention one thing that could can be used in present tense as well as in past tense. But when you use could in the present tense, it means you are indicating possibility in lesser amount. Okay, in place of could, if you use can, you are indicating possibility in a stronger sense. But if you are using could in the present tense, you are indicating possibility in the weaker sense. Okay. The economy's external, actually this word is not count but account. External economic economy's external account, because count doesn't make much sense here. Economy external account could come under pressure, but it is no cause for worry. Now here this phrase seems to be incorrect. In place of it is no cause for worry, we can say there is no cause for worry. Okay, it seems better. There is no cause for worry. As the balancing of payment, but now balancing of payment is the wrong term. The correct term is balance of payments. Now, balance of payment being singular, this stays is correct. So, in this particular part, this part is correct. Could come under pressure. So here your answer is second. Let us see the next question, the charts on digitalization by payments. The charts on digitalization of payments. The charts on digitalization of what? Digitalization of payments. Balances in Jandhan accounts and an extent of cash. Now, when you combine two noun with the help of, that noun becomes particular. Okay. The charts on digitalization of payments balance in Jandhan accounts, and in place of and you have to say the extent of cash in relation of GDP show. Now show is correct here because we are indicating that the subject is plural, and this plurality is being indicated by this word and. Okay, here the subject is plural, that is why we are saying show. Of GDP show. Now in place of on doesn't make any sense here. We can say no sustained effort. So in this question, this part is wrong. This part is wrong. This part is wrong. And this part is correct. Third part is correct. So here your answer is third. Let us see the question number five. Scientists have developed a newly system. Scientists have developed what? They have developed a new system, not newly system. Okay, because newly being a adverb, it cannot modify noun. So in place of scientists have developed a newly system, you have to say scientists have developed a new system. That, now this use is wrong because we are talking about system. This use is connected with this system, and system is singular. This system is singular. So that is why you have to use here uses. So this part is also incorrect. For online authentication and found it to be, and found it to be, it is not being found, but they found it to be. Okay, so in place of this being, because we are not talking about the continuous tense, we are talking about a static situation, and a static situation is indicated by be not being, and found it to be more user friendly and secure. I think this part is correct here. Secure than traditional. Okay, so this part is wrong. This part is wrong. This part is wrong. And this part is correct. So in question number five, your answer is four. I hope you understand. Now let us see the next question. Question number six. The staff. This is staff is wrong. Staff is never written this way in plural form. Staff of four public sector banks has been alleged. They have been blamed for something. They have been alleged by some people. Okay, they have been alleged that they have done something wrong. Try to understand this sentence. They have been alleged. Okay, they have been blamed by some people because they have done something wrong. Now, this part cannot be used in passive voice. Here, because they have done something, the subject has done something. Okay, here an action is being done on subject. So, here this passive voice is correct. But here you need active voice because they have been alleged because they have done something. Now, subject has done something. So, that is why this part has to be in active voice. Here you need to clear your active voice and passive voice concepts. They have been alleged. They have been alleged for what? They have been alleged that they have salted away. They have frauded something. Okay. They have made the fraud. They have been salted away. In place of have been salted away, you have to say they have salted away. Okay. Or kind of misappropriate. They have salted away depositors' money. They have salted away depositors' money by which way? By misusing. So this misusing is wrong. Here this in is wrong. By misusing the latest Aadhaar-based authentication. Now there are two terms, later and latter. Now this later is used in terms of time, and latter is used in term of position. So in place of this later, we have to use latter, because here we are talking about the two parties. Okay, the first party is staff of the banks that have been alleged, and second party is these people who have alleged. Okay, so these are the two parties. Now here we are talking about the latter in term of position, not in term of time. So in place of later, we have to use latter. Now here staff is wrong. Here alleged to have salted away, this is wrong. Depositors money by is wrong. By misusing the later is wrong. So in this particular sentence, all are incorrect. Question number 6, your answer is 5. I hope you understand and it helps in attempting banking exams. Now let us see the question number 7. He had the little formal education yet produced volume and volume of fiction, drama, memoir and journalism through his life. Now this is the keyword here. This yet is the keyword. Through this word we create a kind of contrast between the two sentences. Now on the one hand we are saying he produced volume and volume. He produced good work or excellent work despite the fact that he has little formal education. Although he had little formal education, he produced volume and volume. Now again here you have to understand the concept of little, a little and the little. Little, a little and the little. Now little is negative in sense, a little is positive in sense, and the little means whatever you have completely complete amount that you have in your hand. So here we want to indicate something negative, that we want to say that he had almost no education. So to indicate this meaning, we have to say here he had little formal education. He had little formal education yet produced volume after volume. When we combine two singular nouns and we want to indicate that one after another, we use this phrase. For example, year after year, week after week, day after day, book after book. Okay, so in the same sense we can say here yet produced volume after volume of fiction, drama, memoir and journalism, not through his life, because through is used for medium. We have to say throughout his life. Okay. So this part is incorrect. This part is incorrect. This part is correct. Okay. And this part is also Incorrect. So here your answer is third. Question number 7, your answer is third. Let us see the next question. Situated at the confluence of means at the crossroad of two ancient, situated at the confluence of, this part seems to be correct because there is no error. Situated at the confluence of two ancient center. Now, two being plural is followed by a plural noun. Two ancient centers of civilization, the Indian subcontinent or China. Now, or means either this one or this one. You can say this or simply indicates that Indian subcontinent can be replaced by China. That is not correct. So here you can say Indian subcontinent and China. Indian subcontinent and China. Assam has most unique. Now, unique word is not preceded by these kind of words like more and most. Because if something is unique, it is 100% unique. You cannot say more unique or most unique. In the same way, you cannot say more perfect, or you cannot say more square or more round. These phrases are wrong. So here you have to delete this part. So in this particular sentence, I think this part is correct. Okay. Two ancient centers, Indian subcontinent and China, has most unique. Yes, here this is wrong, here this is wrong, and here this word is wrong. So question number 8, your answer is first. Let us see this question. In the market, people know roughly. Now, if you look at this entire sentence, this part seems to be grammatically error free. In the market, people know roughly. This part seems to be the answer of this question, but let me go through the entire sentence for the explanation point of view. What is stainless steel? Now, here, is this a question? If it was a question, there would have been a question mark here, but this is not a question. So that is why you have to write this particular part in affirmative. Okay. You have to write this. What stainless steel is? In the market, people know roughly what stainless steel is. So this part is incorrect. But how much carbon or chromium content? You're talking about the quantity of something in something. You're not talking about table of contents that present in the book. You're talking about content or quantity of something. You're talking about what carbon or chromium quantity is there in stainless steel. So this content word is wrong. Necessary for calling it to be. Now this phrase is also wrong. In place of calling it to be superfluous. You can say necessary for calling it stainless steel. Cannot be definitely agreed upon. So in this particular sentence, this part is correct. This part. What stainless steel is, but how much carbon or chromium content necessary for calling it stainless. This is a very tricky question. Now, these kind of questions are quite common in all banking exams. And you can solve these kind of questions only through practice. Because here, the sentences are not checking your grammatical part. But they are checking your understanding of English language. Okay. Now, question number 10. The Serious Fraud Investigation Office is being arrested. Can you arrest an officer, or officer will arrest somebody? Here again, active passive voice concept is involved. Serious Fraud Investigation Office is being arrested. You cannot arrest Serious Fraud Investigation Office. Now the office will arrest somebody. Okay, please try to understand this thing. The Serious Fraud Investigation Office has arrested. Now in place of is being arrested, that is completely wrong. You have to say has arrested. Now has arrested whom? They have arrested Bhushan Steels, formerly promoter. Now promoter is a noun here. A noun is modified by adjective. So in place of formerly, you have to say former. Formerly promoter Neeraj Singhal, after an investigation was conducted in the company. Investigation is not conducted in the company. Investigation is conducted on the company, not in the company. Because company is being investigated. So investigation was conducted on the company, okay, in place of this word. Now on also on is also applicable to the promoter, on the promoter and on the company. So on will be the correct word here. So the serious fraud investigation office is being arrested is wrong. Bhushan Steel former promoter, formerly promoter is wrong. Neeraj Singhal after investigation was conducted on the company. This part is correct. Okay, Neeraj Singhal after investigation was. This part is correct. So in this particular video class, I have included 10 most important sentences, English sentences that is most likely to come in next forthcoming banking exams. They are highly useful for IBPS CLERK exam also. I'll continue to upload these kind of video classes in Hindi and English language. So if you like this video class, kindly like it, share it with your friends. Do send me your final comments and do not forget to subscribe this channel called English Advantage YouTube channel. If you want to join my paid classes, the links are given in the description box. From there, you can join these paid classes. So thank you very much for watching this video class, and I'll see you in the next video class. Thank you.